bit about myself, and kind of an update on where I am right now. A few months ago, I had started some yoga devotional videos, and a lot of interesting things have been happening in terms of what God is doing in my life and what He's done in my life since I first started. When He first called me to start the videos, I definitely was scared and I had a lot of fear of rejection and humiliation. I talked about that in previous devotional videos, so I won't go back to that, but I just kind of wanted to give an update on what God's been doing in my life. My Christian walk has been kind of a bumpy one, and the best analogy that I've come up with for that is just, I feel like God always had me in the palm of His hand, and yet I always kind of had one foot out. And by having that one foot out, I feel like that gave the enemy, or Satan, a foothold on me, and basically was his opportunity to rob me of the fruit of the Spirit. And why I had that one foot out, you know, I don't know, just big-headed, stubborn, stupid, unwise, wanting control, being a control freak, wanting power over my own life, arrogance, thinking my own way was better. I mean, you name it. Maybe it was that I wanted to have fun, you know? I think a lot of sin starts out as fun, unfortunately. So I think it's been recently I realized, you know, whatever foot was sticking out, once I got that back in, and it was just like, Lord, I'm all in. I surrender. I submit. Now my pathway is straight. He's using me more. And, you know, the fear of rejection and humiliation, you know, it's interesting because I feel like the easiest way to get over your fear is really to go head straight on and face it. And it's interesting that, you know, when I started these videos, there was actually a lot of rejection, more rejection than encouragement by far. And somehow in dealing with that rejection, I have become stronger. You know, I'll probably always care what people think of me on some level. You know, I'm only human and I'm fallible in that way. But definitely I care a lot more now, not how people feel about me, but how people feel about Jesus.
Tune in tomorrow for part 2 of my testimonial as I talk about anger, bitterness, and resentment.